Hello, welcome back to my project. This is Eric. The product in my hand is WT32-SC01 Plus from the company Wireless Tag. It's based on ESP32-S3. Also, as the base model name suggests, it has 8MB flash and 2MB PSRAM, which is not bad. Compared to ESP32, it supports a large, high-speed octal SPI flash and PSRAM with configurable data and instruction cache. Other than this, the more practical point is that S3 has 45 GPIOs, namely 10 more GPIOs than ESP32. So if you are struggling with the lack of GPIO of ESP32 on your project, there is no doubt this S3 will be a good choice. But still, ESP32 is working fine, so the point is you choose the right MCU for your project. All good. From now on, let's take a look at the display of this device. Because I manage the projects that use displays, the use of display is very important for me. In one of my previous videos, I compared a couple of products on the market. In the test, SC01 performed very well. It's also the only device running at 80 MHz. I think this device probably has the fastest device interface speed of any display with SPI interface that works on ESP32 based. Please check my video for detailed results, it's pretty interesting. As many GPIOs are available on S3, we have more space to use 8-bit parallel connections rather than SPI interfaces. Also, it means that data can be transferred from the MCU to the display at a faster rate, allowing for faster screen drawing. The devices prepared here are SC01 of ESP32 and SC01 Plus of ESP32-S3. I'm not trying to compare the ESP32 and ESP32-S3, what I'm focusing on is the display. First, SC01 is using ST7796S, not ST7796. This SPI interface is connected to the hardware HSPI interface of ESP32. The operating clock frequency can reach 80 MHz. You know what, if I use the typical ST7796 and set the clock frequency at 80 MHz, the graphics are broken. Plus is using ST7796 UI, unlike SC01. 8-bit parallel connection is used, which is MCU 8088-8-bit. So of course, you should be able to draw graphics quickly. Looking at the result, Plus was faster in all tests except for the parts where it drew the line. If you look at the total time taken, you can see that it's about 60% faster. For this test, I used the LovyanGFX. LovyanGFX's enhanced algorithm shown the better performance. As far as I know, the only graphics libraries that officially support 8-bit parallel connections on ESP32-S3 currently seem to be ArduinoGFX and LovyanGFX. TFT-LCD is currently in preparation. ArduinoGFX officially supports this display module, so I expected it a lot. But unfortunately, it shows very low performance in conclusion. It doesn't seem like full support yet. I'll try again later when a new version comes out. This time, let's do a simple LVGL performance test. This is my LVGL project for Tesla website made with Skyline, LVGL's official UI editor. If you need more information about this, check out my LVGL project. I did the animation effect when moving to the next page. Animation takes a lot of resources. The higher the FPS, the better for smooth screen transitions. In the case of SC01, you can see the FPS dropping to 7 while the animation is running. On the other hand, the Plus model never goes below 13 FPS. This means that if your user interface has a lot of graphical elements, you'll need an 8-bit or 16-bit connection rather than SPI interface to make it smooth. It looks better because it allows for much smoother animation effect. This is the official performance test code provided by LVGL. Suddenly, I guess the Plus model will overwhelm SC01 in every way. Let's wrap up today's video while waiting for the results. Most of the projects I do require displays. This is because it's very intuitive to have a display when ESP32 needs to process something and show a screen of results. There are so many graphic ICs available on the ESP32. Among them, what I want to find is the fastest way to draw the screen while using ESP32. I also prefer larger screen if possible, because sometimes I need a user interface. I don't think the difference between ESP32 and ESP32-S3 is huge, so if you need to use a lot of GPIO, choose S3. Otherwise, use ESP32. That's it. This is how I choose one. The important thing is which display to use. As a result of testing, ST7796 shows the best performance, so I think I will use this graphic IC. The question is whether the display being used in SC01 and Plus can be purchased separately. The SC7796 they use is slightly different, so using the 80 MHz on SPI connection was not possible with the regular ST7796. I'm not sure how they made it possible either. Anyway, these two devices are great. If you are working on a project that requires a user interface, I recommend you consider using it. Today's video ends here. Hopefully this helps your project. Thanks for watching. See you on the next project.